which is the annual invitation to all Catholics households to support the work of the ministries of our diocese. The goal for this year's appeal is $3.3 million. Our parish share of this goal is 103. Holly. No, I did something wrong. Ow.
There we go.
Sorry, Deacon, as teachers don't use these things. Good morning again, and welcome to Holy Spirit Catholic Community. Happy Easter to all. Last month, the Diocese of Boise asked for a commitment to the Idaho Catholic Appeals, which is the annual invitation to all Catholic households to support the work of the ministries of our diocese. The goal for this year's appeal is $3.3 million. Our parish share of this goal is $103,684. To date, we have received a pledged gift totaling $74,062. We are confident that we can reach and exceed our share of the goal. Please remember we will receive back all funds collected over 100% of our parish goal. If you have not yet made a gift to the then we urge you to answer the call. For those who are visiting here today, we are glad you have joined us and we wish you a warm welcome. Our celebrant today is Father Henry, assisted by Deacon Scott. I know I wasn't.
You're good. You're good.
is risen, to him be glory and power for all the ages of eternity. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, with the joy to know that our Redeemer is alive, let us come to him and ask for forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, your resurrection brings hope to your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, your resurrection brings new life to your people. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your resurrection calls us to witness to your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Exultant with Paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
From the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness, and everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and in your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Christians. reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. It's been a very long winter. It can feel like we've been in the tomb. And now suddenly the stone is rolled away, the snow is melting. You probably won't have to shovel anymore. This is a wonderful gospel. It shows Mary of Magdala, it shows Peter and the disciple that Jesus loved. In John's gospel, John does that intentionally because you are that disciple that he loves. He refers to that disciple in that way, and you are constantly with Jesus in John's gospel, and here you are running to the tomb. They have an inspiration. They run. They want to find Jesus. Like a very long winter, they believe that Jesus is dead and that all their hopes are crushed. And I think that's something that in this day and age, many of us can relate to as well. It's not only this very long winter, but sometimes we feel like our nation is broken and divided and we feel like, can we ever come together? Can we ever be unified again? The economy's down. If you want to learn how to lose money in the stock market, I can give you lessons. Rents are up. Mortgage prices are ridiculous. And it just feels like it's very hard to survive right now. And I think this is the way that Peter and John and Mary Magdalene felt at this time. They even wondered, had somebody stolen the body of the Lord? But they have this inspiration. At the very end, we hear, the other disciple, that's you, also went in, the one who had arrived first at the tomb, running faster. And he saw the burial cloths. That's what this decoration in front of the altar is meant to depict. It's the place where Jesus' body would be laid, and then there's these cloths strewn there. He saw. And he believed. He had this inspiration. It's hard to have that inspiration. It means you have to be a mystic. In this day and age, to believe that someone can rise from the dead, to believe that you can rise from the dead, you have to be a God-inspired mystic. And we think to ourselves, how can I possibly be that? And yet it's easy. God makes it easy. God rolls away the stone. All it really takes is responding to that inspiration within, that still small voice that says that God is more powerful than our problems. God is more powerful than the disorder that's in the world. God can bring together what is broken. That's the whole history of the Bible. Everything you read in the Bible is God bringing together what is broken. Our God truly is the God of surprise and can overturn all of our expectations. But I want to tell you a simple and practical method to have hope, to believe in the resurrection, to even have hope that this nation can come together and be unified, that we can start listening to each other again instead of just turning off to all the people that we believe are different. How can this happen? What's a simple method to do this? There's a wonderful Catholic author. His name is Matthew Kelly. Some of you already know about him. And he has a little book that came out last year. I was very impressed by it. It came out in 2022, and it's called Holy Moments. Holy Moments, a handbook for the rest of your life. And what Matthew Kelly simply recommends is that we just need to allow God to work holy moments through us. Now check this out. We're not talking about a holy year. We're not talking about a holy month. We're not talking about a holy day even. We're not even talking about a holy hour. We do those holy hours in the Catholic Church quite regularly, every Thursday in fact. But we're not even talking about a holy hour. We're just talking about a holy moment. And what is a holy moment? I'm going to let Matthew Kelly tell you what a holy moment is. A holy moment is a single moment in which you open yourself to God. You make yourself available to Him, like running to the tomb. You set aside your personal preferences and your personal interests. You set aside your ego. And for one moment, you do what you prayerfully believe God is calling you to do. These holy moments are really tiny collaborations with God. They involve mercy. They involve forgiveness. They involve bravery, sometimes choosing to do what is right when everybody else is feeling lazy. A holy moment is helping someone who feels crushed to arise. A holy moment is helping a child who is lost. A holy moment is spending time with your mother or your father or a family member who is lonely. These are holy moments. They're simple. You don't need an advanced degree in theology to do them, and you don't need a lot of practice either. You respond to that inspiration to do that crazy thing that you know is right. Sometimes you heard people a while back saying, do random acts of kindness. Well, this is better because they're not entirely random. You're involving God. You're listening for that tiny collaboration with what God would want. So you become, over time, a God-inspired mystic. Someone who can actually believe in resurrection from the dead. Someone who lives in the aftermath of the resurrection and walks in this world with that power. That person is you. You just need to practice these little holy moments. And what would happen if even just a few of you today responded to the inspiration of God and made a holy moment in our world? What would happen today? Listen to this. Holy moments are one of the most powerful forces on earth because you're cooperating with the providence of God. One seemingly insignificant holy moment can produce a tidal wave of goodness. There are no small acts. No act infused with goodness can ever be considered small. By the way, Mother Teresa used to say, every act of love, no matter how small, becomes infinite. There are no small acts. No act infused with goodness can ever be considered small. Every act of goodness triggers more goodness. How often we have been triggered by badness. How often we have been triggered by irritation. But now we can trigger others into goodness. They're right there. They're right on the edge of being a God-inspired mystic. They just need the witness of someone to do it in front of them, and then they will mirror that and respond to it. Each act, however small, sets in place a chain reaction of holy moments. You never know who will be impacted by the succession of holy moments that you begin. If you do this, if you allow God to work through you, you will have faith. If you get outside of yourself and your own problems for a little bit, your problems are important, but if you take the focus off yourself just here and there for a moment or two and serve someone else, your faith will increase. You will become more certain that God exists. Truly, I'm not bright enough to give you any proof that God exists. I can't give you a formula or a piece of theology that will absolutely prove to you that God exists. However, you can be certain of the existence of God because you will encounter the Lord in the people you serve with your holy moments. Not only will you help heal them, triggering a tidal wave of goodness, but you will help yourself. Your own faith will be confirmed. The stone will be rolled away from the tomb, and guess what? The tomb that we all feel we're in will become a womb, and you will be born from those moments of brokenness into a disciple of Jesus. Because never forget, our Lord and Master suffered brokenness. And from that tomb, he came forth to new life. The tomb became a womb. And that is there for all of us. So very simple, holy moments, a handbook for the rest of your life. But you don't even need the book. I just told you the book. I'm sorry, Matthew Kelly. You can do this. You can start today. I hope that all of you will trigger a tidal wave of goodness in your homes, in your neighborhoods, in your city, and guess what? It will ripple out in this nation and in this world.
Not made consubstantial. death to grace and life. Confidently,
we raise our prayers to the Holy One.
That the whole church in this Easter season feel
the faith and enthusiasm of the first Christians
spreading the good news. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all in positions of authority be the yeast that transforms society and heals our fragile earth. Let us pray to the Lord. That those who have received the Easter sacraments continue to grow in understanding of the paschal mystery of the Lord's death and resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord. And that all who gather today to celebrate the Lord's rising from the dead and who share in his body and blood recognize him, the Lord, in one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of glory and power,
we thank you for the resurrection of your Son. Hear the concerns we offer you through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for the children's offering.
Children money that is collected on Sundays here goes to help a shelter that receives people who don't have any opportunity to be on the roof. Old people, sick people, children who are orphans. This is a group of religious brothers who have taken this responsibility, but they don't have any assistance. So by the grace of God, the money that children give here in this church allows them to buy food month by month. So this is the way we contribute to charity and helping a specific program that doesn't have much by way of resources. So thank you very much, children, for helping.
Yeah. And now we have the big people's collection.
Our offertory song is Worthy is the Lamb, number 583. Worthy is the Lamb, 583.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Joyful with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is beautifully reborn and nourished. Our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
only right and just, our duty and our salvation, to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Of all holiness. May holy therefore these gifts we pray by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given out for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Pope Francis and Peter Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have done you mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. I may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Informed by divine teaching, we dare
to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always seen and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other sign.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For all who are participating in this Mass at home, let us now pray the spiritual act of communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Oración espiritual de comunión. Creo, Jesús mío, que estás real y verdaderamente en el cielo y en el santísimo sacramento del altar. Os amo sobre todas las cosas y deseo vivamente recibirte dentro de mi alma. Pero no pudiendo hacerlo ahora sacramentalmente, venid al menos espiritualmente a mi corazón. Y como si ya os hubiese recibido, os abrazo y me uno del todo a ti. Señor, no permitas que jamás me aparte de ti. Amén.
the body of Christ.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'd like to say thank you for the music. That was beautiful this morning. And the many hours of preparation Deacon Scott and Father Emil went through with altar servers, retreats, and all kinds of actions to prepare for the celebration of Easter. Thank you very much. Yeah. I'd like to share with you an Easter miracle that happened. All of you know that Father Gabriel, who was in this church in 2016 for a year, and presently is the pastor of the church in American Falls and Aberdeen, had a car accident, and he was placed in our hospital here in Pocatello, had to be in a ventilator for 14 days. We were not very excited about the recovery, but something happened. Holy Thursday took him the sacrament of the sick, and I asked him, "Do you know who I am?" And he moved his eyes to where I was. So that was the first time he made any response to commands. Good Friday, like Jesus, but not like Jesus, he said, "I am hungry," to his sister. So she offered him some, to bring him some enchiladas, to which he smiled. And yesterday I went to visit him, and he was much more alert. He said, "I'd like to send thank you to all of you for all your prayers." He's still a little bit confused in things, and I suspect being in a respirator for 12, 15 days, and then all the medicine that went on to keep his body out of pain made you confused. I asked him, "Do you remember the name of your bishop?" He is from Mexico. He's very young, but he's from Mexico. Guess what? He remembered the name of the first bishop he had in Mexico. It was Alberto. He said, "Alberto." He said, no, it's Pedro. He said, "Well, that's as good as I can think." So we are very happy to see God's work among us. I think this whole community has been put to test to make this intention to ask God to help him. And God has answered your prayers and our prayers with this news that I'm giving to you. So thank you very much, and continue to pray for full recovery.
And Father, yes. Let's also ask our community, our beautiful community, to pray for the other party in the car accident. That person wasn't hurt as much physically, but was hurt very much emotionally. And that person has been praying for Father Gabriel. And so let's keep that man in our prayers too. He's a beautiful man.
And this Catholic celebration wouldn't be finished without asking for something. So the Hispanics are raising money to do this Eucharistic Congress. So there is food for sale. What day is today? The 7th, the 8th, the 9th?
The
9th, the 16th, and 7 days more. That's 23. And two Sundays, they will they will bring the food after this. They're selling enchiladas and combination plates, $15 a plate and $25 dozen of enchiladas. In the back, there is a sign-up sheet. They hope, and they've been getting your support with two activities. They raised more than $4,000 to that program, so please help them.
This will be, as far as I know, I've been here a while, this will be our first Eucharistic Congress in Pocatello. It will be up at the Mountain View Events Center. It will be Saturday, June 10th, pretty much all day. There will be teaching, preaching tracts in English and in Spanish. Both communities will join together for praise and worship. So please help us put this on. I think it will be something very beautiful for all of us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Our 74th song is Alleluia is our song number 174. Alleluia is our song number 174.